Divided tongues as a fire appeared on them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages, we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days, it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy, and I will show portents in the heavens above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. For we do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I still have many things to say. like a woman in labor. And of course, not only is creation broken, we all know that humanity is broken as well. Martin Luther once described humanity's sin, that is, Luther described the brokenness and the sinfulness that afflicts all of us. He described that as being inwardly curved or turned in on ourselves instead of being turned outward toward God and neighbor. Now just think back to the headlines over the past year and some months. From hoarding to the temptation to selfishly put our own wants before the needs and safety of others, the headlines of these past months have revealed our brokenness. That is, the headlines revealed the inwardly curved nature of ourselves and all humanity. The impact of this pandemic to creation, to humanity, and to ourselves, the impact reminds us that all creation, including us, all creation, and we are in the midst of painful labor. And not because God planned the mutation, and not because God in cruelty sent the virus as some kind of virus, but rather because both creation and humanity are broken and are in need of a new life that only God can give. And so along with creation, we await the end of what Paul compared to labor pain. We also await the fullness of a future life-filled rebirth that we can first glimpse in the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. Now, as you know, the beautiful thing about childbirth is that the process eventually comes to an end in a child, a new life is born. That is the future hope of labor. That's what makes labor worthwhile. And that is where St. Paul positions us. Paul positions us in a world and a humanity that right now is enduring pain, and yet is looking into the future for hope of new life. The life that only God can bring, that only God can give to us. But now in these days, St. Paul says, we have been given the very first fruit of this new life, which is the Holy Spirit of God. Today is Pentecost. Today is the birthday of the church. Today is the day that celebrates the gift of the Holy Spirit. And what a gift the Spirit is. The Spirit calls us to faith, and it gathers us as the church, the people of God. Not only that, the Spirit of God, Paul says, the Spirit of God even fills in the blanks of our prayers. Sometimes in life, in times like this pandemic, the fact is sometimes we just do not know what to pray for, how to pray, or what words to use in prayer. The pandemic and all little ripples and great tidal waves that have crashed through our lives, the pandemic has often left us without words. And the pandemic is not the only time we are left scared and speechless. There are other times known only to each one of us. So you and I, we do not always know what to pray or what words to use. But here's the good news. We don't have to know what to pray, because as St. Paul told the Romans long ago, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. We do not know how to pray as we ought, but that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God who searches the heart, knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. Yes, the Spirit of God.